Welcome everyone. In today's class, we are going to discuss the last part of the lesson, the Earth in the solar system. So let us begin. The Earth. The Earth is the third nearest planet to the Sun. In size, it is the fifth largest planet. It is slightly flattened at the poles. That is why its shape is described as a geoid. Geoid means an Earth-like shape. Let us see why Earth is called a unique planet. Conditions favorable to support life are probably found only on the Earth. The Earth is neither too hot nor too cold. It has water, air, which are very essential for our survival. The air has life-supporting gases like oxygen. Because of these reasons, the Earth is a unique planet in the solar system. From the outer space, the Earth appears blue because its two-third surface is covered by water. It is therefore called a blue planet. The Moon. Our Earth has only one satellite, that is the Moon. Its diameter is only one quarter that of the Earth. It appears so big because it is nearer to our planet than other celestial bodies. It is about 384,400 kilometers away from us. The Moon moves around the Earth in about 27 days. It takes exactly the same time to complete one spin. As a result, only one side of the Moon is visible to us on the Earth. Now let us see if the Moon has conditions favorable for life. Now the Moon does not have conditions favorable for life. It has neither water nor air. It has mountains, plains, and depressions on its surface. These cast shadows on the Moon's surface. Look at the full Moon and observe these shadows. It may, however, appear at different times, in different shapes, and at different positions. You can see the full Moon only once in about a month's time. It is a full Moon night or Purnima. A fortnight later, you cannot see it at all. It is a new moon night or Amavasya. On this day, you can watch the night sky best, provided it is a clear night. So let us quickly revise